April 6, 2024. How's it going, guys? I got another video for you. And what are we going to talk about? Kansas City, Independence, Missouri. We're going to talk about crime. We're going to talk about drugs. And we're going to talk about the homeless. And a lot of activity tonight, this evening here. So, went to the psychic fair today. And then I left a little bit early because I was going to eat dinner over here at Wendy's. And the first thing you notice, there's a Independence police vehicles going down Nolan. First one, two, three, four, and there was even a fire truck. And off up here across from where Sutherland used to be over there, off to the other side, this would be on the north side, there's some kind of antique store or whatever over there. And that's where they had chased somebody, it looked like. And I noticed when they had the back of it open, now this was probably nothing, but it looked like there was a whole bunch of white trash bags, like this big. Maybe it was just their clothes, whatever. But it took four cars. And they got them. Now, whatever it was, who knows? But if that was dope in there, man, they got a big haul on that. If it was, because there was a lot of bags in that back of that vehicle. And this is a Toyota Rave. It's kind of like a Suzuki, like what we have, but it's a Toyota. It reminds me of there's a Toyota Rave that sits down there at the tool shed. All the time sets out there in front. I mean, they're kind of unique because they're older vehicles, kind of like that now and stuff. So I'm going to show that. I'm going to show where the police had it. Then on the way back tonight, on top of that, I got passed two different ways all at once. And I'm going to show that too. It had sirens blaring both ways tonight. Here in Independence on Chrysler here. Also noticed there was still activity going on at that 7-Eleven up there. Oh God, you know, they just keep moving that dope. And then later on tonight here, as we're about after 10 o'clock, had a boomer. I mean a booming, shaking the whole neighborhood. And I was getting ready to go back out. And went down the street and just seen where this thing went. And it was a silver Cadillac. And it goes up into that, hold on just a second, guys. I think it's called a, is it Country Valley? Let's see here if I can find that. Yeah, I think it's a Country Valley subdivision. And I was thinking, yeah, well, they're the ones that are moving that dope. And that stuff. So, but they're living, you know, they're not the ones walking on the street shriveling up from the drugs of the fentanyl and the meth and everything. Well, they're living in the higher class area. And they want to make sure their flow of dope keeps going. So maybe Independence, State Highway Patrol, Jackson County Sheriff likes to hang down on 40 down there a little bit ways. By that creative world on down the road there, maybe they could come up a little bit past the tool shed and check that out. I'm going to show that too. Because I just wondered, I followed a couple other ones over here on 47th Street way back. This is a couple years ago, and they went up in that area. And I'm just thinking that maybe there's something going up and on in that subdivision. I mean, it's like Lake Lackawanna, too. I mean, everybody knows Lake Lackawanna's got some drugs being moved in that area, too. And they come up over here in this area. But we'll go on from there. So let's take a look at this. All right, guys. So here's Independence. And like I say, they're right here on the in front of this is a rave. Yeah, maroon. And like I say, there's not a, I mean, there's some around, but in this area, not too many.
And I just thought that I used to see, like I say, there used to be one that used to sit down there at the tool shed all the time. What I found interesting when we pulled up here, I didn't catch from the front side because the dash cam couldn't see it. They had the back open, and I could see like bags, white bags, all over the back end of this thing. Now, maybe it was just close, you know. But this thing actually looked like it had a tag on it. It didn't look like it had a temp tag. So that makes me wonder about this. But boy, they were in a hurry to get here on this deal. So, and it was off on the side of the hill too. Yeah, buddy. But hold on, we got more. All right, guys, and we're down here, 23rd Sterling, coming back. We just got off the interstate, you know, from being up there at the casino. And, you know, like I say, independence just keeps on rolling. Keep on rolling those drugs in. Well, sooner or later, you know, maybe they'll all die off here. But we're going to see a guy on a bicycle here. He looked like he was about 40, 45 years old with the backpack. Now, you notice there's another gentleman sitting up here, too. Up here up against this, let's see if I can. I want to make sure you see that up against this wall. And there's a homeless woman. It's leaning half over here, off by that pole, kind of on the off this area. And this thing area is notorious where they've been, you know, like they're drugged up or high. I've shown this before. But let's get on first with the bike. Let's watch this first. Oh, don't blink. Yeah, look at that. 45 years old, 40 years old, riding that bike. And you see the guy up there against the wall. Now, he was connected with that guy on the bike. And I'm just thinking, nah. I mean, wouldn't you be proud to be 40, 45 years old driving a like a 12-year-old bicycle? Oh, but don't blink here. We're gonna get up here and show this lady over up here too. Hold on. All right, guys, that's about as good as I can do to bring that in. But you can tell that this woman, she's hunched over here. And I don't know. I mean, like I say, sometimes they're just completely wasted. And you know, last time there was a vehicle I posted that there was a guy, a biker guy, running something across the way here, across the road here to the Walgreens on the other side. But like I say, he is in pretty fancy clothing, but they in his clothes is pretty fancy there. But this it was a white, I think it was like a Tahoe or Suburban. Anyway, the other guy had the door half open, showing that he was open for business. Now this is Independence, Missouri. This is Price Chopper here. So just to let you guys know. And let's get on with all the sirens and the lights going back and forth on Chrysler. Hold on. Okay, guys. I just pulled over because here comes. Take a look. There goes a fire truck northbound. Now hold on. And here comes a police vehicle southbound at the same time. Okay, guys, now this is my house security cam. And there's that Cadillac that was shaking the whole neighborhood. It goes on down 40 Highway, on down the road here. And I mean, it was shaking the whole neighborhood. But you know, these are the ones that are dealing drugs, but they're not all using them that much because they're making the money off of it. They're living in the high class area. They're not the ones over here on 47th Street and smashing their brains in because they're on meth and fentanyl. But don't worry, let me show you. Hold on. See, I was pulling out because I had to go on back down the roadways, and it was in front of me. And I wanted you guys to see this because this is a Cadillac, but look where it's going. Over there in that, is that, I guess that's Country Valley. Is that what that is there? We'll back that out, but that's where it went. It must be coming down here slumming in their ear, just picking up the money and going back to the high class over their area, huh? I don't consider my area low class, but I'm just getting to wonder because they seem to like to come down through here, but I bet you they wouldn't allow that because it wasn't booming when it was entering in over here. No, because I doubt if they'd let them boom going through that neighborhood like that. So let's see if we can see this a little bit better. Well, there, maybe that's a little bit better view of that. And I do have the tag number off that vehicle, too. So, well, there's where some of them are going. Man, that's probably where some of them are going down to party and stuff. Like I say, these aren't the ones that are smashing their heads in and shriveling up over here. These are the ones that are making money off of them. So hold on. And see, it's turning there on 40 Highway at that Logan Avenue. I think isn't that the Bank of Green Valley that sits there? Well, this is where some of the shaking and boom is going to. Well, we wanted to make sure we got that out there. I know Jackson County Sheriff runs this through here because they were always down here through this area. So does Independence. Maybe even Kansas City, Missouri might want to take a look at this. Because there's a lot of traffic and a lot of stuff going on here, guys. So hold on. All right, guys. I'm back. So a lot of stuff going on. Looked like there was a chase and four police vehicles and a fire truck. The fire truck was already gone. Time got up here on 40 Highway after we ate at Wendy's. And like I say, this vehicle had a whole bunch of bags in the back of it. What kind of bags? I don't know, but they were all white and they looked like they were about this big. And two of the officers were looking in there and they closed the door real quick. I thought, rats, I wish you could have seen in there a little bit more, see what was going on there. Probably nothing. Probably just a, you know, outdated registration, wouldn't you think, guys? A lot of stuff still going on over here. And a lot of activity over here off of Chrysler, too, moving up and down, as you can see. Fire truck, police vehicle. Fire truck, the fire truck would have been northbound. Police vehicle would have been southbound. Then back over here, and this boom, boomer's booming. They're running that stuff back and forth. And oh, yeah, 7-Eleven. Oh, yeah, well, we'll just talk about that. I'm not going to get back in there. But anyway, there was a Tahoe or Suburban white one, man. I mean, there's a lot. There's some out there, but these are the regulars, okay? And it's always moving in. They were off to the corner tonight, and there was another black vehicle. Now, it was really funny. When we pulled up over here, we were waiting to turn. The black vehicle pulls out, okay? And I've seen this black vehicle over there many times before, but it acts like it's going to go on down the road. So after we turn, it turns back into that food, whatever restaurant it is, and then turns back out. You tell me what they're doing. Yeah. Anyway, guys, keep your eyes open and stay safe out there.